I'm Al John Goh, co-host of the Disney List podcast as heard on Sorcerer Radio, as well as Skull Rock podcast, here with my wife, Kristen. Hello.
Hello.
You are an earmarked agent who books Disney travel vacations for people all the time. Give our listeners a reason why they want to give you a call instead of just booking a trip by themselves.
Well, I can do all of the legwork for them. I have expertise. I've been to the Disney parks well over 100 times, so they've got that knowledge at their hand, as well as it saves them time and money.
Where can people get in touch with you so that they can book their next Disney cruise, Disney park trip, Adventures by Disney?
They can contact me at themeparksandcruises@gmail.com. I'm Kristen Hetzel, vacation planner, world traveler, Disney foodie, and theme park fan.
I'm Al John Goh. I'm the husband who's also Disney, Star Wars, and Marvel Comics fan. And together, we host a Disney List podcast.
Every week, you'll hear us list our favorite things about Disney theme parks, films, shows, travel, Marvel, and Star Wars in a top 10 list, rankings, and more.
That's an impressive list. Subscribe to the Disney List podcast on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, iHeartRadio, or your favorite podcast platform. You can even stream us on Sorcerer Radio at srsounds.com and check out our live shows on Facebook. The Disney List Podcast. Visit thedisneylist.com.
Você que está ouvindo o seu podcast, sabia que tudo que o Google faz tem a intenção de trazer impacto positivo? Como? O Jefferson da Tributei usou inteligência artificial para facilitar o dia a dia das empresas. Ele e milhares de empreendedores geraram mais de 188 bilhões com as plataformas do Google. E a Miriane se formou em UX com certificados profissionais do Google, criando o seu próprio negócio. Ela e 88% dos formados relataram avanços profissionais como promoção ou novo emprego. Tem que ser bom para todo mundo. Google.
The Dining at Disney Podcast. The Dining at Disney Podcast. You'll discover all the best restaurants and food as you really explore the Disney parks.
Let's do this thing!
The Dining at Disney Podcast with your host, Kristen, Bubba, and Kat.
Welcome to the Dining at Disney Podcast. I'm Kat. Here with me is Al John. Kristen had to step away and Bubba's off busy today, so we're holding down the fort. If you haven't already, please make sure to like, subscribe, and click the notification bell so you know when we post new content. For those of you new to the show, we now drop two podcasts a week, every Thursday and Saturday. However, we want to know, what day of the week do you listen to new podcasts? Personally, my other show drops on Tuesdays. So if you guys like Thursdays and Saturdays, or if you'd rather have Friday, Tuesday, Wednesday, drop us a line, let us know. Today, we're going to talk a little bit about the 50th anniversary. We're so excited. Al John, do you have any thoughts about the old Magic Band plan?
You know, I didn't mind the Magic Band. I thought it was kind of gimmicky, but then over time, it just was super simple and easy to use. I never had any issues with it. I didn't have any, it wasn't a fashion statement for me at all. Although have a couple, you know, of those special bands. And I ended up getting a Marvel one. And I got the Star Wars, the little Star Wars attachments and all kinds of just goofy stuff for it. But, you know, and I thought it worked just fine. Did you ever have any issues with Magic Bands? Kat, did you have any issues with Magic Bands?
Oh, John, I think I'm losing you.
You're losing me. Oh, no.
Oh, you're back now. Sorry.
Okay, no problem. No problem with this. Yeah, and you froze too. I'm like, oh, no, we're having issues. Uh-oh.
Yeah.
So, no, did you ever? I mean, I never had any issues with the classic Magic Bands, but I don't know if you did at all.
I loved the Magic Bands. I did think that getting them with every single visit was a little bit extreme. Like, it's a lot of unnecessary plastic. The one that I've got, I've used it for years. I love it so much. It's purple. I have like all sorts of jewelry on it, like little pins and stuff that I put on it. So I love it. I can't complain. But all this stuff with Magic Band Plus, we're adding Plus to the end of all of our things now. Disney Plus, Magic Band Plus, Genie Plus. I'm in. Let's do it. Plus everything up, right up.
Yeah, everything is all plussed up. And I don't know, maybe it's an overuse of the term plus, but hey, you know, it's a running change. And they're going to tell us, actually, you're going to tell us all about what's going on with that. So
yes, Yes. So Magic Band was introduced in 2013. It's been pretty successful. It took the place of key cards at hotel rooms and cards to get into the park. You could get them in any color on the planet, themed to any character you could possibly like. But very recently, they announced that they weren't going to be doing that anymore, and that Magic Bands were going to stop being produced, stop given as key cards, everything. Well, yesterday, or today, this morning, one of the two, they just announced Magic Band Plus. So Magic Band Plus is going to be coming out in 2022, next year, as part of the 50th anniversary celebration. And it looks like they're going to be definitely the definition of plus compared to the old Magic Bands.
Okay.
Right? So they will help you enter the theme park the way that the old one did. It will include all of the old things that the other Magic Bands did. Functionality for hands-free things, parks, tickets, resort keys, all of those things that you could possibly want that our old ones did, as well as check-in for dining, check-in for, well, it was FastPass, now it'll be Genie Plus, but also PhotoPass. The new Magic Band will have enhanced capabilities. They're going to come alive.
Okay.
They're going to change colors.
Okay.
It's going to be nuts.
Okay.
Yeah. So let's see here. When you enter a theme park, the Magic Band Plus will come alive at various times with color changing lights, haptic vibrations, and gesture recognition. Yeah. So it will include playing like a bounty hunter in a galaxy far, far away and find virtual bounties throughout Blackspire Outposts and Star Wars Galaxy's Edge at Disney's Hollywood Studios. It will allow you to interact with the Disney Fab 50 character collection sculptures spread throughout Disney World theme parks.
Okay.
I'm seeing a lot of a lot of AR filters in our future, Aljon. I'm really excited about it.
Yeah, this is interesting.
It's interesting. It's going to be crazy.
Uh-huh.
And then this one I'm a little nervous about, but experience nighttime spectaculars in a new way as you see your Magic Band light up and complement the magic in the skies, including the new Harmonious at Epcot and Disney Enchantment at the Magic Kingdom.
Okay.
That one I'm a little nervous about. I don't know if you remember, I forget what it was called, but they used to have the like lights that would change with the show.
Glow with the show.
Yeah, they were so annoying.
I think it had promise. I'll put it like that.
Oh my gosh.
It had like, promise. Yeah. Yeah.
I couldn't handle it. I couldn't. I'm like, if I'm watching a show, I want to watch the show. Like I'm at the movie theater and the person in front of me is on their phone. I'm that person who's like, please stop.
I just feel like it had so much promise, but they didn't really follow through with the choreography of lights to music and different things. And it was just like, okay, well maybe this isn't really working for us. And they kind of abandoned it. Right. So,
yeah,
I don't know, but this is interesting. Haptic vibration. So we're getting into the whole video game of this whole situation. I feel like this is definitely one of those things that remind me of a video game controller and the lights and interactivity, how it's going to be done. Like if a bounty hunter stuns you in the middle of the park or a stormtrooper or something, then you're going to feel it like, oh gosh, I just got shocked. Right.
Yeah.
Or, you know, an Avenger does it. Cause ultimately it'll probably go to Disneyland. Right. So, I guess I'll just have to see it. You know, I mean, I'm down for it. I mean, I feel like they've done so much technology wise. I even said this the other day. I said to Kristen, I wonder if the Pal Mickey still works. If anyone still has Pal Mickey, let me know. I'd like to know if your Pal Mickey still works.
That's a good question.
You know, because we've always wanted to get a Pal Mickey, and by the time we were able to get a Pal Mickey, they stopped supporting Pal Mickey or selling Pal Mickey. So,
yeah.
You know, Pal Mickey would, you know, it's kind of like the droids that you buy and assemble, you know, they interact with different parts of the park and things like that. So it's probably the same technology, I would think.
Definitely close. Definitely close.
Yeah. Well, as long as you're able to have everything linked up, you know, as it pertains to this podcast, we're talking about food and everything. So maybe it'll just have some more ways to make things convenient for people, you know?
I hope so.
Yeah.
We'll see. They'll start rolling out in the new year. They haven't announced prices or anything like that, but I can't wait to see what the upgrades are going to entail.
Yeah. Yeah, me too.
We'll see.
Hey, we will. I find it interesting. I mean, how long has the regular Magic Band been around now?
Since 2013.
It said, yeah. Gosh, it's hard to believe.
I know.
I remember when it was brand new, but you're right. I'm like you. I had a whole collection. I have like a fake Thor's hammer, and then I've got Magic Bands all up and down the handle of that thing. And it was just, you know, I just named myself different characters every time I went. One time I was Iron Man, the other time I was Hulk. So go figure.
I love it.
Yeah.
I love it. Yeah. No, Mom has like a slap band one that she's got. It's so cute.
Yeah. Kristen got herself one of those Magic Band holders that you could put like on your backpack or your belt. So you didn't have to, you just like, here it is, like a key fob, key card, like when you go into work or whatever.
Yeah.
So that was pretty cool. Yeah.
So many options.
Most stuff.
Oh man, there's so many things happening this week. We're recording this on a Thursday, but tomorrow, October 1st, is the 50th anniversary officially beginning at Walt Disney World.
Crazy.
And it's there. I feel like news is just coming every 5 minutes. There's more news.
Yeah. I mean, that's the great thing for what we're doing is that we had a little bit of a lull there because of, you know, our global situation, and here we are now, and celebrating the 50th. And all we can do is just live vicariously through the people that are going to be going. And I know Kat, you guys are going to be going. Yeah.
The countdown is on. Countdown is on 32 days from today.
Yeah. Yeah. And we're saving up too. We're hoping that we're able to bring the kiddos out there and make it happen. Awesome. We haven't been to the resort since prior to the lockdown, but we were still annual pass holders. So now we're just going to get back on this horse and looking forward to checking it out. You know, the last episode we talked about all the 50th anniversary treats. There's over 150 at least. And that's just the tip of the iceberg, according to you, Kat, because you've got the app open and it's amazing. And now here we are, more announcements coming. A lot of our friends are going. It's going to be ridiculous. So
I'm so excited. I'm so excited. Mm-hmm. Let's talk about some other announcements that came today. First being Disney Enchantment is what's taking the place of Happily Ever After at the Magic Kingdom. And Angela Bassett, Queen of Wakanda.
Yes.
Disney, she's not a legend yet, I don't think, but to me, she's a legend. Angela Bassett's going to be at the Magic Kingdom. I'm so excited about this.
And that is awesome.
She's so completely amazing. Definitely a powerhouse. Excuse me. I think it's a great, great add to the show, no matter what the show is, because nobody's seen it yet. But hopefully tomorrow we'll get some updates.
Well, I think I saw on the Disney YouTube page that they were actually going to be doing the show broadcasting streaming live.
Oh, so I love it.
Be on the lookout and subscribe to Disney Parks on YouTube for the live feed that's going to be going on. And I think we are so down with that. Can't wait to watch that on our TV. And
love it.
Yeah. And they have that new original song, right? So Philip Lawrence, cast member who performed at Walt Disney World, has written a brand new song called You Are the Magic, which is, you know, going to be great. We saw clips. So yeah, we saw clips, I think, of them actually producing the entire song on YouTube as well on the Disney channel. So that looks great. But I'm like you, Kat, big fan of Angela Bassett and her work. Incredible actress. And her voice is amazing.
Absolutely. So excited to hear and see that when it premieres. Another new announcement is you'll be able to say, "Hey, Disney," to your Amazon Echo. If you're using Alexa, you'll be able to say, "Hey, Disney," now when you're staying in a Disney resort hotel, which I think is so fun.
That is cool. Like,
I love it.
I love that. And I love it. I'm also a little terrified of it. at the same time. We do have devices, Echo devices here sprinkled throughout the house. They help keep the kids entertained when we put them down for bed. And of course, it helps me out because I'm always listening to the news and listening to music. So this is great. So alarms, timers, all kinds of stuff they have there.
Yeah. And you can even say, hey, Disney, when does the next bus to Epcot depart? Or, hey, Disney, can we have some extra towels? I love that. I think it's so fun.
Dude, that is ridiculous.
It's so crazy. It's so crazy.
Hey, Alexa, so we need more toilet paper, stat.
Hey, Disney, can you order me a pizza, extra cheese, no pepperoni?
Oh, please? My Lord. That's amazing. Oh, that is so great. So, yeah. So it says it helps guests discover more than 1,000 magical interactions, special greetings and jokes from authentic Disney character voices, asking trivia questions, which is nice, in audio environments inspired by Disney films and destinations, which is cool. So I'm down with that.
Yeah. So fun.
I think I'm going to have to get one of those Echo shows for Kristen. She's not on the show right now, but I think I'm going to have to do that because we've got we've got one of those, the Google thingamadoogies with the little, and it's cool, but it's not like our Amazon device. I don't know. I guess I'm just in that ecosystem, but it's pretty dope.
I love it. I think it's so fun.
Yes.
It's so fun.
Yes.
What else? Guardians of the Galaxy Cosmic Rewind over at Epcot is coming in 2022. We've been talking about this one for a long time. I think it's going to be crazy. I was listening to Carly Wazell over on Instagram this morning, and she had some insight. She thinks we're going to get an actual date during Destination D in November, which I think is probably a pretty accurate estimation. Cosmic Rewind is going to be crazy. And it's just the first like little blip of Marvel coming into that area. So
Well,
it's going to be nuts.
It is Space 220's there. Yeah. So I'm just hoping that we have a galactic sword base because we have a SHIELD location in Disneyland. It would be great to have sword over there at Walt Disney World. All right. I mean, can you see what I'm saying here?
But, I would die.
It would be great, y'all. It'd be great. And then, this is a family-friendly adventure. It'll begin in the Galaxiarium, and it's a planetarium-like exhibition exploring the mysteries of the formation of Earth's galaxy and Xandar, of course. Xandar is home of the Nova Corps, and so looking forward to checking out all the Guardians there. And who knows, maybe we'll meet Nova there. That would be amazing for deep cut for you comic book, but that looks amazing. Cannot wait.
So excited. So excited. And our last big piece of news, the Star Wars Galactic Star Cruiser will depart for a galaxy far, far away beginning March 1st, 2022.
That was
so just news. A few. Yes, this is big. It's less than 6 months away. This one's going to be crazy. Bookings for this one-of-a-kind immersive adventure will open October 28th, 2021. So that's just a few short weeks away. Disney pass holders, Disney Vacation Club members, and Disney Visa card members will receive special booking opportunities ahead of the general booking date. So if you're one of those, a member of a DVC member, a pass holder, a Visa card member, you might be, and you're interested in this, you might want to be on the lookout for emails about booking opportunities. We've talked about this one in the past, Al John. This looks crazy.
Absolutely. I'm saving my pennies today because it ain't cheap, but it looks amazing. And no. I will say this. A lot of people jump to judgment. They're, you know, especially the casual, well, even some of the fans that are just not into the Disney parks. Clearly you are. If you're just discovering this podcast, you want to learn more, or you're a hardcore Disney fan like most of us that are already on, that listen to the podcast circle. You know what I'm saying? So the cost of this stay at this virtual cruise, this cosplay cruise, if you will, is expensive. But look at the immersion, right? You've got alien creatures, full makeup, all the LED screens, fully immersive, lightsaber training, excursions, and all of these things where you are literally stepping inside the galaxy far, 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 far away. And it looks amazing. So how much does that cost? Think about how much all of those interactive elements and people and droids and everything that you're going to be experiencing there. This is the Star Wars that we were promised at D23, and now people are going to experience it. And it looks like they're going to kind of try to open it up with the discussion on magic bands and this haptic feedback and getting your status and doing bounty hunter stuff and gaining more clout and those things. Now all those things are starting to come together. Yes, it was a year behind because of the pandemic, but it looks like all of those things are starting to come together so that you can live your actual Star Wars story at that location. So, yeah.
Definitely.
It looks interesting.
I think we're going to hear that those stays are going to come with these Magic Band Pluses as a definite must have for them. Just the interactive features, everything. I think it's going to be crazy.
So what is your favorite one of all those? I know. Which one is your favorite one so far out of all these announcements?
I don't know. I'm really excited for Disney Enchantment. I really am. I'm also really excited for Harmonious. I can't wait to see all of those park icons light up.
Yeah.
I think it's going to be crazy. Just like the testing for Harmonious this week and the ball with this. Oh my gosh. I was great. It was so, I'm so overwhelmed. I just want to see everything.
And you will. And you'll want to follow Kat on her Instagram. She'll tell you where, you know, she can be found, but I'm sure you're going to be posting about it because I'm going to be living vicariously through you
constantly.
When you go to the park. It looks great. And I think another thing we talked about in previous shows, I know on the Disney list and on this, is that, you know, we definitely want to do a meetup sometime next year with the Dining at Disney and the Disney Parks podcast and us and Park Hoppers and Disney List and maybe even Dave Bossert might want to come and hang out too for Skull Rock podcast, all of our podcast family. It would be a really great opportunity for us to hang out with you guys and the fans. So if you want, drop us a note about that thought. It would be amazing if you all did that. And I'm looking forward to seeing everything. But I have to say, having Guardians, a little bit of Marvel on what I will call, our side of the world at Walt Disney World will be super cool because, you know, and I say that kindly because, Marvel over there at Universal is a little long in the tooth. Right. So I'm just saying, It ain't Avengers Academy, yo.
Definitely not. And maybe we'll see, because at Disneyland, we have a Star-Lord who walks around and does a little show, a Groot who does photo ops. So maybe we'll start to see some of those characters walking around.
Well, that's what we're in that area. That's what we're told. I mean, we saw some of the concept art for Cosmic Rewind and you did see all the characters out doing stuff, you know, so this would be amazing to see. And
I love it.
They already tested out that little Baby Groot animatronic over there at Hollywood Studios. And I tell you what, that meet and greet with Baby Groot and Star-Lord was to die for. So good. So good.
I'm obsessed. Ugh, I love Baby Groot.
Right on.
Baby Groot and LBY, little Baby Yoda. Those two.
Oh, that's another thing too, right?
Oh,
exactly. Black Spire Outpost needs to be the emergence of the Force and have the veil of the Force, all that stuff going on there so that they can interact with all the different characters from all the different eras, right? So that'd be amazing. Yes. Anyway, this is just we're just wishing here. That's what we do here on the show.
Blue sky.
Here
on Disney.
Yes. Yes. Well, I don't know if there's anything else we want to add, you know.
Well,
I mean,
I think that's it, huh? I'm sure we'll have way more to talk about next week. Bubba is attending the Oogie Boogie Bash this weekend, and I went a couple weeks ago, so I think next week we'll probably do a little recap of those events for you guys. But I think that's all we have for today.
Awesome. Alrighty. Well, I hope you enjoyed the show. And if you haven't already, make sure you like.
Oh,
did you want me to do that? Because I was like, we're on a delay. Go ahead, Kat.
Whatever you want.
No, go ahead, Kat. I told you, you're
Kristen. I don't know.
Go ahead, Kat.
Okay, we hope you enjoyed today's show. If you haven't already, make sure to like, subscribe, and hit that notification button. You can find us on Anchor or one of your favorite platforms. And if you want to support the show, you can also donate to us on Anchor monthly for as little as 99 cents or as much as $9.99. You can also support us by shopping our links like Amazon, Disney Store, and Garden Grocer on diningatdisney.com. Al John, do you want to tell everyone where they can find Dining at Disney?
Oh, sure. You can find Dining at Disney at diningatdisney.com, all the social media accounts, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube on occasion. Hopefully we'll get that happen. But the best place to do it and hang out with us and click that bell for notifications is Facebook, because that's when we go live. And of course, available wherever you find podcasts. Once again, for all of your Disney, Universal, and cruise travel, you can contact Kristen at themeparksandcruises@gmail.com. for your free quote and to book. And you can also check out other great podcasts like Kat, her weekly podcast released every Tuesday. We love Kat's podcast, Eat the Picture. So please be sure to subscribe to that. Check out Kristen and myself on the Disney List. Also our sister podcast with me and former Disney creative consultant / all around good guy, author and filmmaker, Dave Bossert. It's called Skull Rock Podcast. We're having a panel. We're having a 30th anniversary panel with all these Imagineers coming to you this week on Skull Rock Podcast that drops every single Monday. Disney List drops every single Sunday. And then Park Hoppers with Park Hopper John and Park Hopper Sid. You want to follow them, as well as Disney Parks Podcast dropping every week as well with Tony and John. They are our boys, so please check them out for Facebook fun. Don't forget to check out our friends at Disney Dorks. Thank you so much. Also, Sorcerer Radio, where you can check out the Sorcerer Radio Fun Zone there on Facebook, as well as srsounds.com. Sorcerer Radio, all Disney music all day long. And we are also doing a live stream Sunday night, too, with the Sorcerer Radio crew to celebrate the 50th anniversary. So it should be super, super cool, Kat. All you.
You can find me on Instagram at Catastrophe, at CAT_ASTROPHE. That's our show. Until next time, bon appetit.
Yeah. This podcast is not affiliated with the Walt Disney Company or its holdings and is intended for entertainment purposes.
We did it.
Eat the Pictures is a bite-sized movie podcast. Every week, we look at the ways different movies, from classic horror to rom-com, use food to tell stories on screen. Food unites us all. Let's explore it piece by piece on Eat the Pictures. Stay hungry.